Welcome to Unicorn Dust Designs. My name is Sammy Veltri. On this channel, I do DIYs, wood signs, and there's always tons of laughter. Today, we are hopping into some more spring DIYs, so let's get right into this video.
Starting off the video, I was so inspired by seeing this on Pinterest and knew that I had something in my stash to recreate it. So I got out this little metal envelope that I got at Savers for $2.99. I took the stickers off. I'm gonna go ahead and clean it all up, and then we are gonna grab a new DIY color. Y'all, I don't know how this has not been in my stash, and if it's not in yours, it needs to be. It is called Prom Queen, and it is the most gorgeous blue color. It dries down a lot more pale than it looks now. And I knew right when opening the container that this was going to be a staple for my spring decor this year. And I mean, not even spring. I mean, this is going to look gorgeous. Anyways, enough about the paint. I am taking just a chippy brush. I'm going to do a messy coat for the top coat. I'm not going to worry about the back because it's galvanized metal. It looks nice, so I'm not worrying about covering it. Now for our second coat, I am doing the stippling technique, and this is just so I do not see those brush strokes. It would have done fine with just one coat of paint, but again, I don't like the brush strokes, so I do the stippling effect, and it does dry down pretty flat. There's a little bit of texture, but for the most part, it dries down flat, and then you do not have those brush strokes on there. Next, I'm going to take these beautiful transfers by Redesign Prima. I have them in my Amazon store link for you guys. It comes with 4 sheets, perfect for spring, and they work exactly like the IOD transfers do. They come with our little scraping tool, and then I am just rubbing the image down onto our envelope. I have not cleared it or anything. Paint, and then I put the transfer on. You're gonna grab a piece of your transfer paper and you're gonna burnish that image in. This is just making sure that your image is stuck to the surface of, oh my gosh, you guys, I'm a mess. Anyways, I'm gonna grab the bird nest that comes in here, and this was absolute perfection for this color. The beautiful blue, cream, and white eggs just set this off. Now, don't think I'm like, oh my gosh, Sammy's so creative how she layered these. This image was totally on the package, and I was like, it looks pretty, so I'm gonna do that too. And now I'm gonna put the bird. I added some greenery to the left. This one actually comes with quite a few birds in it. And I thought about doing a second bird, but I thought it was too much with the bird's nest there. So I end up taking some of the green leaves, adding those to the ends of our branches, and then that totally sets it off for me. After I'm done burnishing all of that in, you want to make sure that that transfer is adhered properly. I am going to take my DIY, oh no, I'm going to sand it down just a little bit, just a little bit, just a little bit, you guys. You see how softly I'm doing it? I'm not going overboard. Just wanted a little bit of that silver to show. Now I'm taking my DIY clear wax, and I'm going to coat the entire thing. Now remember, this is your top coat. This is your clear coat. You do not put anything over the wax or else it's going to get sticky and gross. So this is just your last step to clearing it. You can go over your transfer and then you're going to let it dry down. I ended up getting some Spanish moss, sticking it in there with eggs, just like our inspiration photo. However, I did not glue this because I am going to sell it on my website. I wanted someone to have the options of putting greenery in there, using it for its intended purpose. But if you are somebody that buys it, make sure to email me or drop me a note saying if you want this left in there or you'd prefer it out. Next, I saw this beautiful image on Pinterest. So I got inspired by that. And then Erin at Provincial Farmhouse, her sign on the right. I am going to take this piece. I got this actually, I was like, what am I doing here? I'm looking for the price tag. Got this at Salvation Army for $3.98 and it was 50% off tan tag. So it was only $2. And I knew it needed to be in my DIY stash because of the frame that was on the inside. I knew I could do something magnificent with it. So after seeing those two pictures, I knew exactly what piece I needed. I am going to start by taking all the stickers off and cleaning it. Now I'm going to get out those IOD molds and I'm going to use cornstarch and I'm going to do the paper clay. Now please tell me why I decided to do the paper clay again, you guys, because the last time on the cheese box I told you I wasn't going to use it anymore. And I think it's just, I love how pliable it is and how it's very soft and easy to work with, but when it dries down, it shrinks up substantially. Now, I haven't used the regular air dry clay from IOD in a while, so let me know if this is just a common thing with clay that it shrinks up, because maybe I'm just expecting more, not being, a pro at this. So drop it down in the comments if all clay dries up. Anyways, I'm putting this in my mold. This is one of the three trimmings molds from IOD. I get all my IOD products from Bonda at paintedheirloom.com. Her link is in my description box. I'm going to set that on top of my frame and I'm going to cut the excess of this off. And then this is where we're learning lessons, because like I said, this ends up drying and then shrinking a little bit. So make sure if you're using this clay that you leave it just a little bit longer than the frame itself, because once it shrinks up, it'll fit perfectly. And I did not do that here. So there are some spots on there, which aren't that noticeable, but it definitely shrunk back. So I'm gonna continue to do that on all four corners of this sign and cut the excess off, go all the way around, and I'm gonna try Gorilla Glue super glue on this. Now, I have been watching a lot of IOD videos and I see people using different things and I'm always down to try new things. So I'll let you know how this works. It did take a long time to dry. I was able to move it for a very long time, so I will say I did not like that aspect of it. So I end up doing the frame, laying that down. Now I'm going to go back to my molds. And this is where Aaron's concept comes into play. And I guess it was actually in the first picture too, is that she covers the seams of where the trimmings connect together. And I used my mold. These look like little jewels almost. And then I grabbed my bird. Vonda is out of stock of this on her website, but if you sign up for her emails and then heart it, she will send you an email when things are back in stock. So just FYI. After I'm done with that, I'm going to take that super glue, Gorilla Glue again. And let me know if you do molds, what is your favorite medium to use to attach your molds, because I've tried the tight bond, I've tried hot glue, now I'm trying this. I've seen Jamie Ray Vintage use a construction adhesive from Gorilla Glue, so I'm like, ooh, that looks like that's heavy duty, like maybe I want to try that. Because to be honest, I'm like, I would love to sell this, but I don't know how it would ship with the molds on there, you know. I don't know, you guys let me know if you've done it. Anyways, we're going to put those on the four corners. You can see I put the bird over to the left and I am pressing these down. You don't want to press them too hard where it's going to lose its detail, but you can definitely press these down and form them to your frame. After this is done, I was not filming, but I did paint the frame in Water Lily by DIY. Look at that gorgeous bright color. And I promise this is all going to tie in. I did the surrounding area with hazelnut. Trust the process. I know it looks absolutely crazy right now, just like me, but it'll make sense. Once that is all dry, I'm taking my crackle medium from Folk Art. This is in my Amazon store link. And just beware, because there is a crackle medium for acrylic paints and chalk paint. This is my go-to. I know there's a bunch of other ways to get crackle, but this is my way of doing it. I am using a chip brush, and then you want to try and use the less strokes, the better when doing this. After I am done putting that on, I'm going to take my heat gun and we are going to intensify that crackle. Now, if you were on our Facebook Live last Thursday, we made this beautiful little rabbit piece and used kind of the same concept. We did hazelnut on the bottom, crackle medium, and it turned out absolutely gorgeous. So make sure you click the Facebook link down in the description box so you can come to the next slide. Next, I'm going to take this image I created on Canva. My PNG files will be for sale on my website, unicorndustdesigns.com. And I thought how perfect these colors went together. So I am trying to size it down to fit in here. Don't mind my crazy hair. And I am going to take some liquid batina for this. And you could see, I'm finally like, okay, done cutting. I put it in there. I'm going to take my craft knife and I'm going to cut whatever excess off that I need to. And you guys, look at that image up against that water lily paint color. It is so beautiful. All right, now that we're done with that, I am going to take crinoline by DIY. Nope, I'm not, just joking. We're gonna take the liquid batina first. And this is why I didn't care if the paint got in the middle of this frame, because we're gonna cover that up. So took the liquid batina, slid that in. Of course, there was just one part of it that was too big. And so needless to say, my image does not lay flat. There's a little poof here and there, but you know, it's still beautiful. So I lay that down and then I am going to take the liquid batina again after I am done. I'm trying to pop the holes with a needle, but it's just not doing the job here. So after I'm done trying that, I'm going to take the liquid batina and I'm going to coat the top so that we make sure to seal that image in, so it does not go anywhere or fall off. I love that image. It is so beautiful. All right, now we're gonna take crinoline by DIY, which I have been really enjoying. I love this creamy color. I used to use the cashew by Waverly, but the cashew by Waverly has more of a yellow undertone, and that's why I like crinoline so much, because it doesn't. Like, it's a really true cream color. So there's my 2 cents on that. I am going around trying my best not to get any of this paint on to the beautiful frame. My crackle is coming through beautifully. You want to, again, just like when you apply the crackle, when you apply the paint over it, you want to only do one stroke at a time, because if you double up over it, it will take the paint with it and then you won't see that crackle. All right, our final step. We are taking our, actually it's not our final step, but I took, this is Bronzed Age. This is the alchemy wax that I get from paintedheirloom.com. And I'm gonna put that around our whole frame. Now, before I did this step though, I did take this sign out and then I sprayed it with clear matte by Rust-Oleum so that I could clear all of the surrounding paint. You don't ever want to do that after you put the wax on, like I mentioned before. So I cleared it, then applied our bronzed aged, and this deserves a 28 second reveal because it's gorgeous. All of the elements came together so beautifully. I hope you guys enjoy the bright colors of this. I know a lot of you love those Easter eggs from the last video. So if this is like your vibe, if you are all about color, please let me know down in comments because I love this.
Hey everyone, I hope you enjoyed those first two DIYs. We have one more in this video, but I just wanted to stop in and introduce myself. I am Sammy Veltri. I love everything crafty and I am willing to try most anything. I hope you guys are enjoying the content so far. All of my links are always going to be down in the description box, including the links where I get my IOD products and my DIY paints as well. And then I wanted to remind you guys that I am going live on Facebook every Thursday. Last week we made this cutie sign right here. I love how it turned out. That link is also in the description box for you guys. And make sure to check out the links to the creators that I mentioned in today's video. It is Try It Tuesday, which means that myself and other creators get together and we try other people's DIYs out and then we give them a shout out in our description box where you can find their original items. So check out the playlist where other creators are also doing the same thing. And then check out the links to the creators that I'm duping today as well. I hope you guys have a good week and I'll see you again here on Saturday.
DIY. So this is a Pinterest inspiration picture, and I knew that I could take this and make it spring. So I grabbed a piece of wood. I did a baby wipe and the stain method so it dried quickly. Now I'm taking the crackle medium and I'm only putting it in a few spots. I didn't want to coat the entire piece of wood with this, but I did want it looking aged in a few spots on the wood. So I put it around the edge. I put some in the middle in odd spots. I'm going to take my heat gun and then I'm going to dry that up. When you use your heat gun on the crackle medium, it's going to intensify that crackle. And I love this crackle because it dries super fast. Now I'm taking beadboard by DIY and I am going to coat the entire thing. And I also do the back of this as well, since it's going to be a freestanding sign. And right away, you could see that beautiful crackle come through. I did just a messy paint job. And you guys, this is where it kind of turned south on me. But the idea is there. So I took Kissing Booth by DIY, also a new color for me. And I'm going to put it on my IOD stamps. Now, for most DIY paints, they dry down, I feel like, substantially lighter than they look in the container. This one, however, did not. How it looked in the container was definitely how it dried down. So thinking back about the inspiration image, how it was kind of lighter in the background, that's what I envisioned here, like lighter color pink flowers in the background. It didn't quite turn out that way though. So just a note, you can use paints on your stamps. You just need to clean them off right away. You can't leave them sitting. So right after you're done, clean them off with a baby wipe. I even rinse mine off in the sink and then let them air dry before I put them away. All right, now I'm taking this beautiful rabbit stamp. I totally forgot I had this, you guys. It's from IOD. I got it last year after spring, and we are going to be using this a lot. So I did my black ink. I put that down, and then this is where, after I put it down, I was like, gosh, these flowers are taking away all of the rabbit's focus because they are so dark. So I will say, if I were to do this again, I would have probably used Prom Queen, that really light blue, and put the flowers around it like that. Now you could still see the rabbit and its beautiful details, but what catches your eye are the flowers, which I didn't want. I wanted the focus to be on the rabbit, but this will be available on my website as well. If any of you are digging it, hopefully you'll find a home for it. Thank you guys so much for spending your time with me. I always enjoy being here with you guys, and I hope you have a good day.
I like how I just keep saying hopping. Like, it's no pun intended. It's just like, it's just the word I'm using. I don't know. I like how I got my hair done and I never wear it down. Okay. That's because Mama's busy.